Hey guys, today's video is about gain ratio. It's actually a modified version of information gain. So if you don't know what information gain is, please check out the videos about information gain in my channel. To briefly recap, we first use the entropy to calculate the information gain. Then we select the attribute with highest information gain to split down. Entropy is the expected information required to classify a tuple in a database. Therefore, information gain is just the entropy of the whole database minus the entropy of individual attribute. Here are the formulas for entropy, but I won't discuss these formulas in detail now. The point is, because we use this formula to calculate the entropy of individual attribute, the information gain has a problem that it favors attributes with many classes. To solve this problem, we introduce a new measure, gain ratio. But it's not a brand new measure, we just modify information gain a little bit. In fact, we only introduce one extra variable, split information of individual attribute, and we use this variable to normalize the information gain and to solve the bias issue. The formula for split information goes like this. Dj is the number of data points in a certain class J. D is the total number of data points in the attribute A. Most importantly, the meaning of split information is the potential information generated by splitting data into V partitions. That's why we can use this split information as a unit and balance the bias towards multivalued attributes. Since split information is like a unit, the normalized version of information gain is just the information gain divided by the split information. And this number is exactly the gain ratio. Let's look at an example we saw in the previous videos. Student is attribute A, and buying computer is our target attribute. In other words, the purpose of model is to predict whether a person will buy a computer or not. In the previous videos, we figured out the information gain of the attribute student is 0.021. To convert information gain to gain ratio, we need to calculate split information of attribute student, and I put the formula here for reference. To illustrate, J is a class of attribute student, so we need to know how many classes are in the attribute student. It's pretty obvious that attribute student has only two classes, and there are three people in the class yes, two people in the class no. Then, we just plug in a formula and we get the split information 0.971. If you look carefully, you can see we only use attribute student to calculate the split information, so we actually don't need the target attribute here. And that's it. Gain ratio is the information gain divided by split information, which turns out to be 0.0219. Last, I want to remind you some points. The first one is that, like information gain, we select the attribute with the highest gain ratio to split down. It's because gain ratio is just a normalized version of information gain, so we use the same selection criterion. Next, we should know which attributes we need to calculate certain variable. For information gain, we need to know the entropy of the database and the entropy of individual attribute. To calculate the entropy of the database, we use target attribute only. However, to calculate the entropy of individual attribute, we need both the individual attribute and the target attribute. Then, we use information gain and split information to calculate gain ratio, which is a normalized version of information gain. As we talked about, information gain is the entropy of database minus the entropy of individual attribute. For split information, we need the individual attribute that we want to split on only. If you are confused, please check out the definition and the example of these terms. Last, gain ratio prefers attributes with unbalanced splits. In other words, if the attribute has a class which has a much larger size than the others, then its attribute's gain ratio tends to be high. This is a problem just like information gain favors attributes with many classes. Therefore, instead of sticking to one measure, you should check your data and find which measure is more suitable. That's the idea of gain ratio. Thank you for watching my video and hope you enjoy it.